Now, but the most significant factor in my view is still, and this is as much my failing as anybody else's, to keep the Philippines very sharply within the radar of the most significant travel organizations around the world. Mm. Our major challenge is still to penetrate huge streams or huge mainstream markets, the United States, Western Europe, etc., the traditional strong sources of more market leader countries like Thailand, for example. We still haven't made significant inroads. We have to continue to assess the type of investment that it takes to do that now. It is very easy to talk in terms of precisely creating overarching strategies that first will govern our role in aviation in this part of the world, and then, of course, the role of the various agencies around it. But you cannot do that without a fundamental transformation in the attitude of people. And as I began to say, part of the exercise in the Aquino administration has been, first and foremost, to change the attitude of the people towards their own country. Fun in the Philippines was as much directed at the Filipino as it was to the foreign market. We had to be convinced
ourselves
that this is the role we were meant to play. I have the fortune or the misfortune of being the only Secretary of Tourism who had to have the President of the Philippines approve the campaign and then have to present it to the Filipino people. By accident of history, because of the previous campaign that people demanded to see what the
tourism...
Yes. Fortunately, they got behind it. Kasi sabi ng Pilipino siguro, we may not be amazing, we may not be incredible. If nothing else, we are fun. The truism about the Filipinos' willingness to allow visitors to participate in their culture, in their joy for life, is a very significant advantage. When I started, I had to grapple with that. What promise could I make today? This was in 2011. What promise could I make the world today that I knew I could deliver on? The only promise I could make was about the people. If you looked at all the surveys, the Philippines as a destination didn't rate as highly as you would have wanted it to. But if you did the survey on the Filipino, we were above so many other. In other words, the people have always been our strength. But the important job was to make sure that the people themselves were convinced of that. So that was job number one. And believe me, that takes over a year and a half just to do.
Since 2013.
We ended up with over 80,000 versions of It's More Fun in the Philippines. Every Filipino had his version. I keep telling people, my least favorite version is the one, the streamer I saw, I think it was in Baguio, where somebody said, the civil service is more fun in the Philippines. Sabi ko, yan lang ang hindi totoo siguro. But all the rest was actually contributed by the people. And I cannot overstate the importance of that. No? Country brand marketing, in the case of the Philippines, was an exercise in nation building as well. We had to get the people behind the campaign.
I think you're succeeding because in the case of sa Facebook, makikita mo, for example, my son, he went to Puerto Galera, he posted it in his Facebook. It's more fun in the Philippines.
That is correct.
And dami Facebook users sa Philippines.
And you know, to some people, it's a small achievement. In my view, as a marketing person, it is a very significant one.